Hello everyone and welcome to TPCC4 known as the Highway and Railroad Engineering. Alright, good day everyone. For today, we will continue the second part of the chapter 3 known as the Railway Engineering. So on this chapter 3, we will continue and we will discuss the types of curves. So right now, based on the railway, we will encounter some curves, no? So there are two types of curves. The first one is we have the horizontal curves. So the horizontal curves provided when there is a change in alignment of the track, circular or parabolic transition curves are provided at either ends. Mean to say, unsa dai ning horizontal curves? Ang horizontal curves are curves or kurbada that allows the train to move from either left or right, no? So naka makakuan siya, makahimo siyang turn nga left and right. So wala man ang kuan man gud ang train man gud is wala siya kuan, no? Unlike sa kanang vehicle sa road nga pwede siya manually nga mahimo sa driver nga palikuon na from left to right. Pero ang atoang train man gud dire is sa railway, tagagad lang siya sa atoang release, and that release will guide the train to move from either left or right direction, no? So next is we have the vertical curves. The vertical curves provided when there is a change in gradient. So this sometimes it refer as the parabolic curve. So ang kining vertical curves class slope or ascending na slope, no? So if we have an ascending slope, kinahanglan siya provided og vertical curves. Otherwise, ang mahitabuan na sa train is medyo kana bitong pag naay change sa gradient, so mura siya og mahimong bangil, no, sa pagsaka sa tuang train. It should be nga swabe ang iyang pag transition from one grade to another. So it could be either ascending or descending, no. So to give you light the two, so we have horizontal curves. Ang horizontal curves is pang move nga left and right. Samantalang sa vertical curves is we have ascending and descending. So we have the classification of curves. Okay, we have the, okay, ang pinakauna was the simple curve, no? Simple curve is an arc of a circle which commonly used in the horizontal curve. Pinaka-common ang simple curves because ang simple curve mango dire is somewhat na siya given nga radius, and at the end anak niya na siya kuan na siya, no, straight na siya, no. Then in compound curve, so the difference between the simple from the compound curve, ang compound curve is the combination of two curves with different radius, no. So ang simple curve, isa lang siya ka curve. Samantalang sa compound curve, duha ka curve. Pero lain-lain sila og radius. Pangutana, sir, is it possible na pwede sila magparehas og radius? Pwede, pero mura ra gyapon siya, wala siya kalahian sa simple curve. Kaya nga naman, kung parehas siya, mura gyapon siya simple curve. So, the compound curve is composed of two curves, but it should be at different radius, no? So, what's different also from compound curve, from the simple curve, it has also na siya ay common tangent, no? Okay, next, we have the transition curve. So, para sa din yung transition curve? Ang transition curve class, now, in order para smooth ang ato ang pagkurbada sa ato ang train, ang purpose ang transition curve is to prepare the train to pass steep nga curve, no? So para dili makalitan ang ato ang train gikan sa straight, padulong dito sa may steep nga kuan, pasabot sa steep ba kana bitaw medyo hait nga kurbada. So para marikaya nato ang derailment, dili siya malabay ang ato ang train. So kinahanglan nato hatagan siya og transition curve, og centrifugal force, no. Okay, So the transition curve is also known as a spiral curve. So it is a gradual change from the tangent to curve necessary for railway in order to have a smooth transition from straight to curve without the risk of wear and tear. So mao na siya yung purpose niya. Okay, then we have the parabolic curve. Ang parabolic curve is para ni siya sa vertical curves. Okay, so para makuha na ko, no? Makategorize na ko. Okay, from simple curve up to the transition curve, so mao ni siya parts sa tuang, type sa tuang horizontal curve. Samantalang kining sa kuan, vertical curve, we have the parabolic curve, no? So the parabolic curve refers to the vertical curve which can either summit or sag. So summit, it could be in ascending, tapos ang sag is descending, no? Okay, so it is very useful to design the ideal profile grade for the rail. So para sa any class, no, kini kay iska ko same ani. So ang kini nga concept gi-apply gyapon nat ni siya sa train, no? Kay kung wala tay parabolic curve class, gi-allow lang nato nga siya nga straight dire dapita, no, ang iyang grade from one to another. So ang kining portion dire nga sharp portion, posible nga masangit ang ilalom sa to ang train, no? So muna nga tong gilikayan, which should provide a smooth transition of this grade, no? So mao nang silbi sa parabolic curve. Okay, then so let us proceed to the parts of the curve, no? We have the degree of curve. So the degree of curve defines as the angle subtended at the center by the chord of a length of 100 feet or 30.48 meters. So ang kining ato ang degree of curve class, it gives the edge of the curve nga we have, it is assumed nga in every 30 meters sa railway na siya equivalent degree, no? And that degree is what we called as the degree of curve. Pero kung sa highway ni siya class, this one is instead nga 30, 20 meters ni siya, no? Okay, so to calculate your degree of curve for the railway, so we have d is d over 30, murag ratio and proportion na to, no? The degree of curve equivalent from the 30 meters segment. And we have 360 degrees, the complete interior angle of the circle, and the circumference of the circle, which is 2 pi r, no? So kung atuan na siyang i-simplify, we can calculate the d, which is equal to 1720 over r, which is the radius of the curve, no? Okay, next. So, steep curves are prohibited by these factors. So, pwede ta makaprovide ng steep curves, but it should be based on the following, no? So, we have the wheelbase. So, if the degree of curve is greater than the wheelbase of the train, so the wheel will be having a difficulty on running along the curve and therefore it is prone to derailment. Meaning to say, unsa rin yung wheelbase. Ang wheelbase na to, class ka ng distansya na to sa ligid sa ato ang train, no? So distansya. So kung ang ato ang kwando nato class, ang degree nato is degree of curve is greater, no? Pasabot ang ko bang mas dako daw ang atong degree of curve, meaning to say pag dako ang degree of curve, the more siya mas kurbada kayo, no? Liko kayo, bawg kayo ang iyang dalan. So kung mas taas daw ang iyang degree of curve compare sa iyang wheelbase, so na tendency nga ang ato ang wheelbase masangit siya, no, ang kining iyang ligid. Kaya ang atong ligid diri sa atong train naka-straight lang gyud na siya, no, naka-design lang siya for straight lang gyud. But it should be nga ilikay nato nga maghatag ta og kurbada, which is ang iyang atong train nato kining ligid sa atong train, it should be nga masampak gyapon siya, no. Kay kung dili na siya masampak class, posible nga magawa siya sa release. So munang gitawag na to nga derailment. Then we have the sharpness of curve. So the train will need more effort of hauling on curves than on straight path, no? So super elevation also increases with degree of curve and should be limited to keep the vehicle stable against gravity and centrifugal force. So what's the purpose of super elevation? So sama sa kong gi-mention tong before, that the super elevation will allow the vehicle to maintain its center of gravity maskin pa og kanang pakurbada na siya. Kung pakurbada nimo na siya, butangan nimo og slope diri sa kilid siyang cross section, so it will resist the It will resist the vehicle to be affected by the centrifugal force. So meaning to say, pag maka-resist siya sa centrifugal force, maka-maintain siya sa iyahang center of gravity by the help of super elevation. Okay. So, what is the maximum degree of curve for every type of railway? Sa broad gauge class, we have 10 degrees ang allowable. Sa meter gauge, we have 16 degrees. Sa narrow gauge, that is 40 degrees. Okay. Sa super elevation or cant, okay, the another term for the super elevation is cant, no? Which refers to the portion of the railway which the level of the outer rail was higher than that of the inner rail of the horizontal curve in order to maintain the vehicle's balance over its weight and the centrifugal force acting to it. Okay, so the super elevation was provided by these obvious reasons, of course, to counteract centrifugal force, no? So maugi na pinaka importante. Trains can maintain its speed without the risk of overturning or derailment kung naay super elevation. Okay, maintain man niya iyahang kuan, center of gravity. So dili na niya kinahanglan pa mo minor, no? So magpadayon lang siya siyahang gi-maintain nga speed without the risk, no? Without the risk of overturning. Okay. So reduce wear and creep of rails, no? Then we have equal distribution of wheel loads on two rails. So equal distribution meaning to say pag kuan man good, pag let's say kung wala center of gravity class, wala center of gravity, wala super elevation, ang tendency man good ana niya pag action niya gliko, ang pika side lang niya ang mo pass an sa weight. It's because ang sa pikas kay maalsa man ang sa pikas, no? Pag maalsa ang sa pikas class, wala halos gikarga nga weight ang sa pikas or less lang ang iyahang gikarga. So ang the rest nga mga weight niya sa nga gikarga sa rail na to was na dito sa pikas sa may outer, no? Kay patakilid man siya, no? Okay. So then it also provides smooth running on tracks. Okay. So of course pag kuan siya class, pag pa-kurbada, pag na super elevation, so di na nimo kinahanglan ng minor og diretso lang ang imong dalan, smooth siya, no? Okay. So, we have the limit for super elevation. Of course, na limit ang ato ang super elevation. Dili pwede nga mapasumbrahan ang ato ang super elevation. So, the maximum super elevation is always 10% slope. So, applicable gyapon niya sa kuang class, no? Sa highway, 10% gyapon ang ato ang maximum slope. So, super elevation must be provided with transition curve as an approach of a circular curve. So when it comes to one class super elevation, since that super elevation is provided on the circular curve, di ba? So dapat provide dan daw siya og transition curve kay para smooth ang iyang transition. So para dili pud siya mabigla, no, when it comes to pag-agi niya sa super elevation. So with all the design class, no, we compare na to ang railway from the highway. Mas masulti na to class nga dire sa railway is medyo mas kinahanglan na to precision sa ato ang design, no, sa when it comes to the geometry and the specifications. Dapat masunod gyud na to ang dire sa may railway. Unlike sa road or sa highway, pwede man nga maka-adjust ang vehicle. Pero ang dire magod sa railway is dili maka-adjust ang train, no? Kaya ang train naka-agad lang gina siya sa atuang railway na to, no? Design sa atuang railway. Okay, so the super elevation varies from zero at the beginning of the transition curve to full amount at junction of transition curve and circular curve. So we have the maximum super elevation per types of track. Now this one is in terms of centimeters. Sa broad gauge we have 16.5, sa meter gauge we have 10, and we have the narrow gauge we have 7.6. Alright, so let us proceed to cant deficiency, no? So it is the difference between the permitted maximum super elevation and actual super elevation. So the cant deficiency therefore Okay, so kung makita ninyo dire, it is the difference between the maximum and the actual, no? Okay, so Kant deficiency is limited in two reasons. So higher Kant deficiency can cause discomfort. So pag medyo taas-taas daw ang value sa itong Kant deficiency, it will cause discomfort. And higher Kant deficiency can cause extra pressure and lateral force on the outer rim. So it should be nga, minus-minusan lang po nato ang ato ang Kant deficiency. So it should limit on these two reasons. Okay, so the maximum Kant deficiency is limited on these different types of truck. Sa BG is we have 7.6 centimeters, sa MG is 5.1 centimeters, and sa MG is narrow gauge, we have 3.8 centimeters. Now, what will be the relationship between the super elevation or E, then we have the gauge, and we have the V or the velocity or the speed and the radius of the truck, no, from this given figure. So unsa ang ilang relationship? So we can derive a formula out of this figure class, no, from the super elevation, given that we have the centrifugal force and we have the weight of the vehicle, no? Okay. So from this formula class down to this formula, so at magka-come up ta og formula nga we have the super elevation is equal to the gauge multiplied by the velocity of the train, okay, squared over 1 to 7 times the radius. So what are the gauge values class? Okay, we are all familiar with the gauge values. So gihatag na nato ni siya tong sa picas part. So the gauge values mo ni siya tong width sa ato ang gauge, no? Okay. So for broad gauge, what that is 1.676, and for meter gauge that is 1 meter. And for narrow gauge that is 0.762, no? Okay. So we have the speed of train. Okay, so the speed of train class can be calculated by either of these following three. So it can also be classified, no? Napon siya tulo ka klaseng speed, no? So the first one, we have this safe speed. Ang safe speed is the allowable speed for the purpose of safety, no? Of course, kung mag-kuan ka, in order for you to resist the makalikay mo sa derailment or unsa pa na diyang mga types of accidents with regards to safety issues sa tuang train. Okay, so you'll just run on at the required safe speed, no? Then if for the sake of kuan medyo for the sake of speed class or time, considering time, so you'll go with the average speed, no? So this applies only for BG and MG nga types of railway, no, gauge, no. Then we have the maximum speed, allowable permissible speeds on super elevated curve. So applicable lang ni siyang maximum speed sa portion nga na ay super elevation. Okay. Now, for the safe speed class, okay, safe speed or speed which is safe from the danger of overturning and derailment with the certain margin of safety. So, kining safe speed na to class is given na siya dito sa may portion sa may circular curve. So, kay para dili makuha na to, malabay ang ato ang trend. So, this speed is dependent on the strength of the truck and the power of the locomotive, okay, gauge of the truck, the radius of the curve, the super elevation, and the presence or absence of the transition curve. Okay, so in order for us to calculate the safe speed of a train, okay, so we can use the Martin's formula. So this portion right here, this formula, these formulas can only be used if when there is a transition curve, no? Kung naay transition curve, kini nga formula tong gamiton. So for BG and MG, we can either make use of computing the safe speed. Let us say V is equal to 4.35 square root of R minus 67, or V is equal to 4.1 square root of R minus 70. Ang R nato dire class is the radius of the curve in meters. Meanwhile, ang ato ang speed is it should be in kilometers per hour ang iyahang result. While in NG or the narrow gauge, we have V is equal to 3.65 square root of R minus 6, or V is equal to 3.6 square root of R minus 6.1. Pangutana, sir, naaba sila kalayan. Well, there are just naslay slight nga deficiency sa ilahang kuan class, sa ilahang result, but nonetheless medyo doldo lang kun sila og result, no? Okay. So, next is what about kung walay transition curve? So, the maximum speed that is allowable sa tuang safe speed is 40. Samantalang ganiya is 50 pag naay transition curve. Okay. So, kung walay transition curve, that will be 40 lang, no? And also, the speed is also reduced by 20% or only 80% of speed calculated at step A. Kung if ever man nga na given ang atuang speed, no? Okay, so we'll just simply make use of 20 or only 80% of the speed, no, calculated sa tuang step A. By the way, kini siya nga formula class is magamit pa ni siya sa tuang mga sunod nga speed nga tuang i-calculate, no. Okay. So we have for BG or BG and MG. So ang atong formula nga gamiton to calculate the maximum safe speed on or the safe speed we have 3.52 square root of R minus 70, and we have V is equal to 2.92 square root of R minus 6 for NG, no? Okay, sir, what if kung ang ato ang speed na to dire is mulampas og 40? Okay, so class dili na gini siya mulampas dapat og 40. Maximum speed naman nato is 40, no? Okay. So it should be nga atong expected value dire is lesser than 40, no? Okay. So dire class the same rapod, no? It should be nga maximum lang nato is 50. Pero kung mulampas ang atong gi-calculate dire og sobra 50, so atong gamiton is 50 lang yun, no? Okay. So next. So for high speeds, no? High speed nga safe speed. So we have ang V na to class if ever man, so that will be is greater than 100 kilometer per hour. So either we can make use of the velocity nga formula for high speed equal to 4.58 square root of R. Okay, so how about the average speed or the equilibrium for the average speed? So to calculate the average speed, no? So if the average or the maximum speed is greater than 50 kilometers per hour, so average speed is the least of the either of the following, meaning to say least pinakagamay, no, nga value. So we need to perform or investigate the values of each of this formula. So either sila hang duha makaproduce sila gamay nga value, mauto ang atong gamiton nga average speed. Okay. Kung given ang maximum speed, no, Vmax. So kung just in case sa maabot sa problem class, kung given ang maximum speed, i-compare nato sila either anin duha, no. So depende pod sa kung ihatag nga criteria. So if the Vmax is greater than 50, okay, you can make use of this condition. Pero kung ang Vmax nato is lesser than 50, you can make use of this condition, no. So ang kalayaan silang duha, so kung greater ang Vmax nato or the maximum speed is greater than 50, mag-apply ta og 0.75 dire sa to ang Vmax, no, multiply nato siya and that is your average speed. Okay, so balik ta, no. So if the Vmax is lesser than 50 kilometers per hour, so ang ato ang average speed is equal na na siya to Vmax. But we should try to make use of the formula of safe speed in the Martin's formula. Pangitaon, atong i-compare na to kung asay mas least nga value sa ilaha. So kung kinsa may mas gamay sa ilaha, mauto nga ito ang average speed, no? I-declare nga average speed. So how about kung naatay weighted average equilibrium speed, no? So meaning to say equilibrium speed, naatay mga different types of speed given and the quantity of speed or quantity of number of train that applies on that speed. So to calculate their average speed, so we will make use of this formula. We have a series of number of vehicles, a number of train, times the number of equivalent speed, no? So by this, we will get the average speeds of all those trains, no? Okay. Next, we have the maximum permissible speed on the curve. Meaning to say, maximum, no? So lahi ni siya sa itong safe speed, lahi ni siya sa tuang average speed. This one is the maximum speed, no? So maximum, mo ni siyang Vmax, no? Itong Vmax. Okay, maximum permissible speed on the curve is the least of the following. So maximum sanction speed of the section. So safe speed over the curve given by the Martin's formula. Speed based on the consideration of the equilibrium cant. Speed from the length of the transition curve. So either of this following condition must comply in order for us to get the maximum speed. So for normal speed up to 100 kilometers per hour, so the Vmax, to calculate your Vmax, it should be equal to 134 times L over the super elevation, no? And or either we can use also this formula. We have Vmax is equal to 134 times L over D, no? Unsa gani na siyang D? That is the degree of curve, no? Then for high speeds above 100 kilometers per hour, we have Vmax equal to 198 times L over E or the super elevation. Then we have Vmax equal to 198 times L over D, no? Or the degree of curve. Okay. So we have the negative super elevation. Unsa man ang negative super elevation? It only occurs when a branch line diverges from the main line. So let us say, for example, if we have a certain track, we have the main track, tapos magsanga na siya. Now this is what we called as the negative super elevation. Nga naman, there is a main track class, if ever man nga naatay super elevation dere, the other one will be unsa man siya? Negative, no? Negative ang iyang super elevation. Supak siya sa tuang super elevation dere nga design. Okay. So for main line curve, outer rail AC mo nang atong AC dere, A tapos C must be higher than the inner rail at BD, no? So meaning to say expected on sa so main track kini dere da pitang rail mo ay mas pinakataas compared to dere sa kininga rail. So for branch line curve, outer rail BF and should be higher than inner rail AE, no? So we have the super elevation at this portion, or let us say higher elevation at this portion, and we have higher elevation at this portion. So this one at the main line, we call that one a super elevation. The branch line is what we called as the negative super elevation, no? So negative siya dire sa tuang branch, sa main track is super elevation ang tawag. Okay, so the train on both tracks must be restricted at a restricted speed. Right, so let us try a sample problem. So let us make it clear, no? With regards to the question. So if a 8-degree curve track diverges from main curve of 5 degrees in an opposite direction in a layout of BG yard or the broad gauge yard, calculate the super elevation and the speed of the branch line. If the maximum speed permitted on the line is 45 kilometers per hour. Okay, so what's the idea here in our problem? So, as you can see, on the first part of the problem, we have 8-degree curve track diverges from the main curve. Meaning to say, this 8-degree curve, it refers to the branch line, no? Then we have the degree of curve of the main curve, which is 5 degrees. Dayon, the problem states that we have to calculate the super elevation and the speed in the branch line. But given the maximum speed permitted on the 45 kilometers per hour, this 45 kilometers per hour here is referring to the maximum speed at the main curve, no? So therefore, what we need to calculate here is the super elevation and the speed at the branch line. Ano may maximum speed sa main curve? Tapos, sa branch line na lang itong kwaon, no? Tanan sa super elevation o sa speed sa branch line. Okay, to get that one first, we need to compute the super elevation of the main line. Okay, wala man tay kopya sa wala dili given ang atuang super elevation sa main line. So the idea here is, in order for us to proceed on getting the super elevation of the branch line, as we know that the main line, tawag na to ang super elevation sa main line is super elevation yun term. Then sa branch line is what we called as negative super elevation. So what will be the value of the super elevation at the main line is the opposite of the super elevation, or is the opposite value of the branch line. So therefore, ang tawag na tuwa na sa branch line is what we called as negative super elevation. So karon, in order for us to determine the value of the super elevation at the main line, first we need to calculate your radius. To calculate your radius, we need to make use of the degree of curve and the radius relationship na formula. Okay, so that is ganong formula ba nga, d is equal to 1720 over r, no? Pero kay gisimplify na to solving for r, so it happens nga r is equal to 1720 over d, which is equal now to, okay, let us make use sa calculator. Okay, we have 1720 divided by the degree of curve at the main curve. So that is equal to radius na to at the main curve, that is 344 meters. Now we can compute for the super elevation of the main line, no? Main track. Okay, so to calculate the super elevation E, okay, we will make use the relationship of the gauge velocity and the radius, no? Na formula. That is E is equal to GV squared over 127R. And so naaman tayo mga values of G na to sa itong BG track, or the gauge value is 1.676 meters. Then the velocity that is in the main curve, which is 45 kilometers per hour. Okay, so using this formula class, take note that ang atong V na to dire, it should be in kilometers per hour. So dili na nato siya kinahanglan i-convert. Okay, so using this formula, solving for E, we have 1.676 multiplied by 45 kilometers per hour squared divided by 127. Ang 127 class, that is the conversion factor na siya. So muna, no need na nato i-convert ang 45. Multiplied by the radius, which is 344 meters. And the result will be in meters of super elevation, that is 0.07778, no? Or if you convert that one into centimeters, that is, okay, you need to multiply this with, okay, answer times 100. So that is 7.768, or we have 7.77 centimeters. Okay, so this is the super elevation at the main line, no? So how about sa branch line? Okay, to calculate the super elevation at the branch line, okay, first we need to calculate the cant for the main track, no? Okay, so if we have the cant equivalent for the BG track, that is 7. Cant deficiency of 7.6 centimeters. So to calculate the cant for the main track, we have E stands for the super elevation nga katong nakuha na to ganiha, minus the cant deficiency from the BG track. So ang nakalculate na to nga 7.77, you should be ato siyang i-deduct na to siya sa, okay, minus na to siya sa 7.6, no? So 7.77 minus 7.6, that is 0.17 centimeters. So ang atuang cut for the main trap is therefore equivalent to 0.17 centimeters. Okay, since the branch track diverges from the main, so it is expected the branch track must have a negative super elevation. To calculate your cut for the branch track, that is therefore just the opposite of the main track. So whatever the value of your cut sa atuang main track, that is negative ana niya, that is the value of your branch line, no? So that is negative 0.17 centimeters. Okay. Now, to calculate the super elevation at the branch line, kigamiton na tong value sa cant nga nasolve na to for the branch track, no, which is negative 0.17 centimeters. Okay. And also, we have the cant deficiency. So kung ganiha, to calculate the cant for the main track, so cant for the main track is equal to E, which is the super elevation at the main super elevation at the main track minus cant deficiency. There is atong isolve man nato is ang super elevation, so it will be cant, the formula will be cant deficiency plus the cant, no, the cant for the branch branch line, no, branch track, branch line, okay, whatever branch line. So we have the cant deficiency is, as you might remember, 7.6. then ang atuang cant for the branch track is negative 0.17. so we have 7.6 plus negative 0.17, so the answer is 7.43 centimeters. This is the super elevation for the branch line. So nakuha na nato ang answer na nato ang first part sa tong problem, which is the super elevation at the branch line. Ang kulang na lang nato is to calculate the speed for the branch line. Now to calculate the speed of the branch line, we need to get the radius first, no? Kay given naman na nga to ang d which is 8 degrees, no, para sa to ang branch line. So to calculate your r, so we have, okay, using the formula, 1720 divided by 8 degrees. And the answer is 215 meters of radius, no, para sa ato ang branch line. Now, to calculate the maximum speed permitted on the branch line. Okay, so gamit tong formula nga, E is equal to GV squared divided by 127 multiplied by R. So given naman na nga to ang E, itong nasolve na nato ganiha, which is 7.43, convert na lang nato siya into meters, no? Okay, naka-centimeter man to ganiha. Okay, so we have, okay, 0.0743 equal to gauge distance, which is 1.676, multiplied by the unknown value of the speed, okay, squared divided by 127, the conversion factor, multiplied by 215, which is the radius of the branch line. So ship solve na to, and we have the answer of 34.79 kilometers, or if we round that off, it will be 35 kilometers per hour. So that is the answer for this problem. We have a super elevation of 7.43 centimeters and a speed of 35 kilometers per hour. So that is the answer of this problem. Okay, so to leave you with an assignment, so what is the equilibrium cant or the super elevation on a 2-degree curve on a BG track if 15 trains, 10 trains, 5 trains, and 2 trains are running at the speeds of 50 kilometers, 60 kilometers per hour, 70 kilometers per hour, and 80 kilometers per hour respectively? Anyway, na mo'y guide. Okay, naman mo'y answer, no? Okay. Then, for problem 2, calculate the maximum permissible speed of the curve of high-speed BG truck having following particular. Okay, given ang degree of curve, which is 1 degree, super elevation at 8 cm, length of transition curve, which is 130 meters, and the maximum sanction speed of 153 kilometers per hour. Okay, so take note, class. In order for you to calculate the maximum permissible speed, it should be the least value from all the conditions, no? Okay, so you have your answer, diredapita, no? Okay, so all I need is your solution to be submitted. Okay, so that's all, I think, for the chapter 3, no? So the part 2 of the chapter 2. So thank you. If you have questions and suggestions, just comment down below. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.